Okay, my friends, we continue. Okay. Şimdi, always before you enter the tank, always take photo. Or you write somewhere the name of the tank. Yani you just start your first photo for the tank inspection is the tank name. Okay. Is important. Okay. So this is TST, maybe DBT tank. Huh? Yes. You see here. Yeah, in the tanks, my friend, when we enter, you see, and but one more important thing and very, very important I want to tell here. One hand for you, okay, and one hand for job. Don't forget, don't forget. Yani, you see everywhere, everywhere is coated with mud. These surfaces are very, very slippery. So when you are walking inside a tank, don't forget, always, always, one hand will be free. Don't forget. And preferably you just touch somewhere, you handle somewhere, and your another hand, you just keep the photo camera something, something else. Okay, oh, but always one hand free and for your safety. Don't forget, in the tank. In the tank inspections, we don't run. Never, never. We don't jump anywhere. Never. Okay. One hand free. Always, my friend. Always. Okay. Always. And one more important thing I forgot to tell. Here, my friend. Pardon. I will also tell. Okay. Yani this, what was the... For example, what I told you, always two person. Okay, two person. But... You know, when you enter the tank, you ask the guy before if he have any claustrophobia. Okay, this is very, very important. Yani if somebody have any phobia in closed spaces, something, never take this guy. And before entry, always ask. Okay, you know, and then it will be very big problem. Yani in one tank, I face this one. Yani we in enter four pick tank with the bosun, and he didn't tell me he have claustrophobia. Yani he when he enter a closed space and narrow small spaces, so he's afraid. He didn't tell me, but when we enter, you know, because the four pick tanks like this and have some floors inside. So when we enter on the first floor. I realized some problem from his face. Yani his face turned to yellow. So I asked him if any problem. So he told me I have claustrophobia. I told him, okay, no problem. Just go. So this is very, very important, my friend. Yani you don't force anybody to come with you. Okay. Yani if anybody have any phobia, so okay, yani we just change. No problem. He stay here. Okay, you just make and come back. But nobody. For phobia. Okay, this is important. I forgot to tell. Okay, also always one hand for your safety, one hand for job. Always no running, no jumping. Okay, always gloves, wear gloves. Very, very important, very important. You see, covered with mud. Yani. Yes. The paint condition is very good, my friend. Perfect, yani. Here, no problem. But too much mud. You see, yani how many? It is about maybe more than 5 cm something in the corners. But in that area, 2-3 cm. Yani not too much mud, but slightly mud accumulation. You know, yes. This is DBT. This is the bilge kill. Okay. And my friend, what I recommend when you enter. Okay, always check if something forgotten. For example, you will see in the vessels forgot scaffoldings. İşte forgotten wire rods. Okay, yani bundle, directly box. And then forgotten, for example, şey wire rods diyorum ya, welding rods, welding cable. Okay, maybe işte paint rollers, Okay. Some bolts, nuts, several things. Yani especially after shipyard. Shipyard. Bu scaffolding dediğim iskele. Sometimes they forgot ladders. Ladders. Everything they can forgot. Don't forget. Maybe sometimes they intentionally leave. They didn't take. Okay. Yani so that is why when you enter the tanks always check if something forgotten. This is important. We check paint condition. We check mud accumulation. We check structural integrity. If any crack, if any broken, okay. Also we check this anode. Okay, yani alüminyum anode. If they are complete. If they are moving, maybe sometimes some loosen the nuts, something. If it is completely removed. Sometimes you know in the shipyard normally this alüminyum cathodic protection işte. So they come fabricated when come from the factory. I change yes. When come from the factory it is covered with nylon, you know. And then they just fix here but forgot to remove the nylon. So if you cover with this one nylon it will not work. You know. So that is why you also check. Yani when you enter inside also check. By your hand. Yani şey by your eyes. So if these are not covered because sometimes forgotten. You know. The nylons and maybe 2, 3 years, 5 years nobody remove and then okay. Yani it is not working. It's mean. Okay. And then yeah, this tank is good condition. You see. Yeah, yes. Yani this mood is not very too much thing. Nothing to do this one. Another. Yes, this is the bilge kill. We just check. Yes. This is the DBT site. Maybe. Yes. Yes. Yes. Also frame something longitudinals. As much as possible we take. We look everywhere. Okay. And what I recommend you, yani how I was making the tank inspection. For example, you know. I draw with this one. For example, this is DBT tank. Okay. And then for example, şöyle yapayım. Şöyle. Am just drawing about. Şimdi you know in the DBT tanks, all the tanks have the inside is have some longitudinals and frames. Correct, huh? So, for example, and each everywhere is cell by cell. For example, this is aft. İşte this is forward. İşte this is starboard. This is port side. Okay. So for example, you enter from here manhole. So what I was doing, when I enter, I take photo. And then, okay. At first, I take photo. And then I enter here, I check that cell. And then, okay, because you know, each manhole, each cell have some small manholes here. To proceed, correct? Small manholes. All of them have. Sometimes sites have some manholes, correct? Easy like this. So at first photo and then go inside check visually. At first take photo and then inside check. So easy I proceed like this and then for example işte I go here at first photo and then check and then I proceed like this final I come here finish. Something like this. So why first we photo? Because my friend, I will show in the photos each before you enter. You know when you enter before you enter the cell top how can I say the floor is covered with mud. But if you step inside, this mud will mix with the water and the surface, the floor of the tongue will be not clear. You will not see. Okay, so when you take photo also in the photos, it will be the water is mixed with the mud, not clear. So that is why at first we take photo, we just check floor by eye with the light, and then we enter to check other spaces. Okay, I will show in the photos what I mean. You see, yani this tank is fair. Yeah, painting is perfect. We just check all the cathodic protection is in good condition. There is no rust, something. You see, this is the, what was the name? Sounding pipe head. Also have some accumulation around here. But always, always it is better to clean here. The, you see this small cell here in the sounding pipe head. Always better. Only that small. Yeah. Okay. Yes. This is another tongue maybe. Oh, you see here mesela too much accumulation. You see this is the rubber boots. For example, if you wear safety shoes, all mud go inside and you damage your, what was the name? Safety shoes very very quickly. So that is why we always wear rubber boots. You see here maybe more than 10 centimeter, 15 centimeter it is high level of mud accumulation here, for example. Also this is, yes, floor. This is the ceiling. Yani here up is tank top, cargo hold. This is underside, the tank top steel. So we always check. You see here, for example, because in the tank top, inside the cargo hold, they, for example, some cargo, something hit from the top and then have some rust area here. So this is also important. And then what we are checking, we check the longitudinals if they are if they doesn't have any waving. Yani you see it is directly straight, no problem here. Also directly straight, no problem. There is no slightly wave something. Yani there is no slight wave. Okay, we just check also this one, yani structural integrity. We just check paint condition. So that is why, for example, before I enter, for example, this is the cell. Before enter, I take photo, because I just take photo from the floor, clear photos, and then I enter. I step back. Ha, here, don't have water, that is why I directly enter. But if have some water and the floor covered with the mud, when you step inside, it will be mixed, so you will not see the floor very well. And the photos will be not clear. Also you see, yeah, this is also good, okay, no problem. Yes. Paint condition is good, my friend, yani in that tanks. But have some mud accumulation, yani this is not good, not good. You see, this is the suction head. Şimdi this suction heads always check, yani visually check. Sometimes what I told you they forgot. Sometimes also they forgot some small pipes, okay, some. Also some cutting disc, abrasive disc, you know, in the how can I draw? İşte the spiral motor, you know. So we just put the disc here and then they just forgot something. And then this, for example, disc, some pipe, something just come here and stuck up. Okay, yani maybe can go inside with the strong flow. Some small pipes I am talking about, not very big thick things. Okay, yani just small cutting disc, something. So maybe it will go to, what was the name, the pump, and then it will be a problem. Yeah, very very difficult, but yeah, these are very small things with the strong flow maybe happen. Okay, also always check if something forgotten. Also you see here, this is the drain plug of the tank, ballast tank. You see, when you enter the dry dock, you pump out all the tanks, minimum tank, you remain ballast. And then when you enter, they open this one from the underside of the ship in the dry dock. So we drain all the water from that one. Also we check this one. If any problem, you see here some rust. Yani if any abnormality here, it is also important. Okay. We check the ladders also. Ladders. Because okay, this is fixed type, but sometimes with nut, some bolt and nut fixed, maybe it becomes slack. Some steps broken, something. Okay, very very important. Yes, this is the general condition. Yeah, very good condition actually. Maybe this is four pick tank, I think. This is a four pick tank. Yes. Especially in the four pick tanks, we always check for the damage, because this is the forward during maneuvering, something maybe in night time navigation, some floating wooden lock for example, heat here, we don't know, you understand. Yani so we always check as extreme damage, especially in the four pick tank. You see very very big accumulation of mud here. Yes. Here is the suction. No, not suction part. I think another something. I think this is, you know, what is this? The what was the name? The Doppler. I think yes, because here some manhole. Maybe this is just the Doppler something for the what was the name the. Maybe speed lock, maybe. We will see. Yes, yeah, we just check, especially for damage, any problem. You see, this is the level alarm, because you know this is the water ingress alarm also in the four pick tank. If you are in ballast condition, you may have some collision, and then here water ingress alarm also. Yes, this is the down. This is the ceiling. Yeah, this tank also good condition. Paint is good condition. What is this? Yes, yeah, I think this is. No, this is what. I think this is, yes, this is the valve for the Doppler lock. Yes. Maybe the echo sounder, maybe the Doppler lock. But probably echo sounder. Yes, this is I think echo sounder, yes. Yes, yeah, we just check like this, işte. Any problem, something, accumulation. What is this? So we, if we can quickly check any problem. Yes, because this is a valve. I think this is for echo sounder. Yes. This is the suction head. We just check, yani if any problem, damage, something stuck up. You see here some bubbles coming. This is remote measurement sounding, remote sounding. Because you know some systems working with the air. They blow air and then with the pressure inside, so they measure the ballast water inside. If some water coming like this, don't surprise. Okay, yani this is the system. Ha, if your system is different, this is problem. This is another story. You see, here is manual sounding, this is the remote sounding. Yani. Remote sounding gauge. This is the valve manhole, işte, four pick tank manhole. Valve. Yes, we just check the ladders, something. And you see, bak, for example, here, this is vertical ladder, but in the floor, covered with the mud. Very, very dangerous, my friend. Don't forget. Yani, always handle somewhere. Yani, one hand, for your safety. Okay, you just move very very slowly. Always in bad weather, never make, because of rolling, pitching something. So it will be dangerous. Okay. Yes, yani. We just check the pipe conditions, something. Yes, this is the chain locker. This is the sounding of the chain locker. Yeah, we just check frames, paint condition, the bulb. You see, here is the bulb. Everything as much as possible. The chrome pipes of the valves, hydraulic pipes, remote operation. You see, just very, very little What was the name? The paint, rust here yani. Void second floor clear demişiz. Yes, this is void space. Ya yeah, when I enter, I also check. You see some small rust. This is the what was the name? Chain locker entrance manhole here. For example, for that void spaces, that you cannot make any ballast operation. So you will make good ventilation. Very very good. Yani always. Maybe one day before, two day before open and put the blowers. One blow, one exhaust. So clean the air inside. Make sure. And before we enter, we always use the gas detector. Correct. Ha, yani. This is the what was the name? Water ingress alarm also. Yani when you enter also check this one. Yani probably inside a boy. So with your finger you just rise the buoy so it has to give alarm in engine room and also in bridge. If it is not working, it will be problem. Chain locker neymiş bu? Starboard suction valve. Yes, ha, this is for the dewatering system. Okay. Okay, yeah, it is like this. Any problem? Almost finish. Yes, tamam. Okay. Is void space. I am just taking photo. Any structural damage, something, something. Is for the stripping system. Adductor. This adductor for what? Dewatering system. For chain lockers, for bosun store. Something, yeah, paint room if have. So you must be familiar with this one. And you have to check if it is working. Very very important. Yes. Kaydetme abi. How many? Okay, so what is this? Not this one. So for example, what is this? TST two port. This is another vessel. Yeah, all of the vessels are different, okay? And the cover all something, all of them not correct. Yani. Yes, dear friends, we continue with the next video. You see here. Yeah, this is when I was first time chief mate. So when I enter, you see some paint cracks. Here, I have already speak about this one in the cargo old hatch cover inspection videos also. What I mean was that you see here some liner cracks on the paint. So you see, now this is mainframe. So it indicates some minor micron cracks in the steel. You see. Because in one tank I saw several like this. Yeah, I just make a number like this, so I all explain to which one. You see, yeah, for this one nothing to do. This is with the ship's movement. Okay. But I made a mistake here. You know what was the mistake? I will show. So yani I just find several location like this and then you see we apply crack test. Yes, have some cracks yani on the steel plating. But for this one nothing to do my friend. Yani this is with the ship's movement. This is ship's structure. For that one, for that one nothing to do. Nothing. So yani we just scratch the paint to make crack test. But I don't recommend this one. Yani if it is just minor, okay, nothing to do. Okay, and then we paint, but we just remove the paint inside the tank. Yeah, what I recommend, don't make any painting inside the ballast tanks, okay? Because handmade painting again will be not good quality. Nothing to do for this one. Okay, if any scratch, yani cracks on the steel. This is just in the micron level, very very little. What can we do? Nothing. It was like this. I don't recommend this one. Crack test, forget. Okay. Ha, if you find any big, okay, this is different. But for just small, no need, no need to touch. Okay. And then you see the problem here in the frame, longitudinal frame. It is waving. You see here. This is what was the name? TST. This is not straight. Have some wave. Actually, this vessel was not a good vessel. I didn't like. You see. Yeah, because of the welding they bent, but this is not a good. Also, this frames very very thin. No good, my friend. This vessel was no good. We also check, don't forget, the longitudinals have some waving. If too much, it will be a problem. Okay. And then this is gone. And then we enter this one. Are we recording? Yes. Yes, this is DBT tank. We just check. You see, this is the head. That is why I told you before enter, take photo. If you enter here, all the water will mix, will be not clear because of the mud. When you step inside, it will start float in the water, the mud. Also, we just check the tank top because if any damage from the cargo hold side, we just check the protection, cathodic protection. Paint is good condition. You see, no damage in the longitudinals, in the frames, not too much mud accumulation, just slight. You see, always one hand for you, always, don't forget. Before enter, I take photo the surface and then we just enter inside. Yes. İşte this is the bilge keel something. I am checking if any damage something, if something forgotten. Okay. Yeah, as you see, most of the, what was the name, the mud accumulation will be in the bilge keel. Okay. And then also the aft part. Yani suction head part will be much more mud accumulation. As much as possible, don't forget. As much as possible, take photo. More photo is better. Don't forget in the tank inspections. This is DBT one port. Okay. We just check if any damage, something, paint problem. Also the cathodic protection. You see, this is from the tank top. The top is cargo hold inside, so something hit. So damage the paint in the ballast tank side. But don't touch this one. Never, never. Just leave like this. Nothing to do for this. What I recommend. Okay. Because inside is very humidity. You see, yani drops here. So if you work here to touch up, so it will be not good quality, my friend. No good. Also, we just check. Also, we check the manhole. Okay. We check frames. We check cathodic protection. This is suction head. You see in the suction head, forgotten something, some pipe. Here, not clear. This is what I mean. Pipe stuck up. And then here become rusty also. But I try to move, but not possible. Yani. You see, this is doubling plate becoming rusty. This is no good. This is stripping line. This is sounding pipe head. This is tank top area. When you enter tank, always keep your eyes open, don't forget, and always be careful, my friend. Always. If something forgotten, any structural damage, in abnormality, any waving in the frames, longitudinals, any crack, any localized, paint, rust, local rust, yani suddenly local rust. Why? You understand what I mean. Also, we check cathodic protection. You see, here we find one damage. This is the outer, this is the bilge keel plating. They just start hit. Yani during maneuvering, vessel hit, touch the pier or something from the side and then proceed, come here, you see. Yani. This is not good. Also bent, you see, in the corner. You see. Yani. And then when we go also you see have some like this, yani damage, bent the shell plating of the vessel. Always keep your eyes open. Yani we just check here, okay, yani nothing to do. You see another bending. Yani force vessel too much. Also some cracks here on the main frame. You see. And for example, this one yani has to be changed in the shipyard. In the 5-year dry docking. Normally. Yes, we just check. You see, this is the outside. So it hit and proceed, but damage inside the tank. So has to be careful always. You see. In any maneuver, somewhere they just touch before and then you see this like this. And bend the shell plating, the hull plating of the vessel. Yes. This is another, and then what is this? Afterpeak. My favorite. Afterpeak is the most difficult because it is the smallest cells. And because of the vibration, always rusty. Too much rust in the afterpeak. This is normal, my friend. Nothing to do for this one. Yani. We just take photo and report. You see. Now, if any major problem, okay, we try to repair, but and nothing to do. Don't forget, afterpeak is always rusty. Always. Because of the vibration. You see. It's very rusty, yani. We just check if any structural damage something. Yes. Bakalım. Yes, yani like this. Yeah, it is really difficult. Very careful in afterpeak, my friend. Don't forget. Yani this is the most difficult. I hate afterpeak really. Yeah, because it is very narrow and always curve, not flat. Yani very very has to be very careful. Okay. And always hot inside. Hot, very hot. So this is finish. What is anything remain? I think finish. So this is what I will tell about the tank inspection. Okay. So we just finish. Thank you very much for watching, my friend. Don't forget, if you like, please like. If you wish, yani. If you wish, subscribe. And if you wish, recommend. And I want to tell something in my channel that videos. Okay, yani just for new chief officers, yani just for new chief officers or maybe officers will just take promotion very soon. Okay, yani just for the new boys. Okay, so yeah, it is only my experience. Yani as much as possible, I try to explain something. Okay, yani when you go vessel, when you gain experience, okay, you will know no need that videos when you get experience. This is just for the new boys, okay? So thank you very much for watching. See you. Take care.